Hello everyone and welcome back to Skyrim. So we are back in Ravenrock because I've looked up some of the locations of the Black Books and I read that I need to go through this mine, I guess, to get to one of the Barrows, and I can't believe I never explored this place. I thought I did. In my head I had the memory of coming up to this door and I guess I just ignored it? I guess? And this is also where we can complete a quest from the blacksmith that I told you about, I think, 2 episodes ago?
Damn it, woman. I said to leave me be.
3 episodes?
Precious, last time you explored the mine, you almost fell to your death. I'm not spending the rest of my days as a widow.
And I'm telling you that I'll do whatever it takes to find my great-grandfather's remains. He's down here. I can feel it.
That was almost 2 centuries ago. There may be nothing left to find.
Just let me go, woman.
Precious, you're an obstinate old fool, and you're going to get yourself killed.
Too big to think too far ahead.
Gore.
My apologies.
Who in the blazes are you? Can't you see I'm busy?
Busy doing what?
Why should I tell you? I don't even know who you are.
Do you see the face? Do you see this mask I'm wearing? I'm Marak. No. Perhaps I could help.
Maybe. Been difficult trusting people lately. They think I'm crazy. But mark my words, these mines hold a secret that could put Ravenrock back on the map.
Do they? And what sort of secret would be hidden here?
A secret the East Empire Company swept under the rug 2 centuries ago. It killed my great-grandfather and left Ravenrock with a worthless, tainted mine.
And who was your great-grandfather?
Gratian Caerellius. He spent his entire life exploring ancient ruins across Tamriel. And he died in these very mines almost 200 years ago.
Good God. How did he die?
The East Empire Company called it a terrible accident, claiming that he was lost in a rockfall. But I know better.
And you have proof?
My wife and I were cleaning out our home. We came across some of my great-grandfather's things locked in an old chest. I found an unsent letter he'd written to the East Empire Company, and a key.
So what did the letter say?
It describes a discovery that was made in the mine by some of the diggers. They wanted Gratian to take a closer look. The East Empire Company must have felt it was of great value, as they locked that section of the mine off from everyone else.
So this is the key to the locked section?
It is. Well, I assume it is. I haven't been able to find the entrance.
Ah. I'll admit, it does sound suspicious.
Finally, someone who believes me. I'm telling you, there's something big down there. Something that the East Empire Company wanted to hide from everyone.
And why would you tell me all of this?
Look. My wife nags that I'm too old to go traipsing around these mines chasing my story. Time's my enemy. It's caught up with me before I could find the answers that I'm looking for.
So you do need my help?
I do. I want to know what happened to Gratian, and what the East Empire Company is keeping from all of us.
Well, do you know anywhere to start?
Gratian kept a journal of notes about his discoveries. If you can find his remains, I'm hoping it will help. Here's everything I have. The letter, the key. Please, do this for me, so I can finally regain the respect that I've lost.
Okay. By the way, Glover wants that ancient Nordic pickaxe you have on your waist.
The damn fool doesn't even deserve to have it. The pickaxe was made for mining, not selling. I'll bet he stole it from the Skald in the first place.
Well, I do know of another one, I guess. Fine, you keep it.
Now you're finally talking some sense. A mining tool belongs in a mining family. Just tell him I lost it or something.
See, are you sure Gratian's death wasn't an accident?
Look, I know I don't have much to go on. I have that unsent letter. And that's really it. But I also have a miner's instinct that's run in my family from before Gratian was even born. I may sound like a crazy old man to you, but I'm telling you, the tunnels here are solid. They would never collapse like that.
I didn't say that, though.
Be careful down there. The mine can be treacherous.
What do you have to say about all this?
Why are you leading Gratius on? I'll never understand.
Wow. Oh, she's a restoration mage. Great. Makes you want to kill her. So I'm guessing you don't agree with Crecius' story.
Poor Crecius is aging. I believe it's addled his mind. As the years have passed, it's gotten worse. He's become obsessed with his theories of conspiracy.
Then where's his great-grandfather?
I'm sure he's down there somewhere. Buried under a mountain of rubble, like the East Empire Company claims. My greatest fear is that my stubborn mule of a husband will end up suffering the same fate.
Do I care? My character wouldn't, but because I've never done this before, sure. How did you meet him?
To understand how we met one another, you have to appreciate what he's going through.
I don't.
Crecius is a third-generation miner. All his life, he's lived and breathed nothing else. By the time Crecius came of age, the ebony mine in Ravenrock was shut down. He took that quite hard.
So why didn't he move somewhere else to find work?
Our home has been in his family for over 200 years. Leaving would have been like abandoning precious memories. Instead, he stayed on Solstheim and spent most of his life prospecting for a new ebony source. Sadly, it never surfaced. A decade ago, this drove him into a deep depression. He shut himself inside his home and refused to come out.
This is where you met?
It was. After refusing to allow anyone to bring him food, Counselor Morvain ordered his door to be knocked down before Crecius starved to death. I was a temple priest at the time, and they had me use my healing arts to restore strength to his ailing body. I stayed for a while and cared for him, then I suppose we fell in love.
It's a pleasant story.
Be careful out there.
Try the lower sections of the mine. I've never been able to get that far.
So, you know, I've always assumed, because Dunmer like an elf or whatever,
I'll never understand.
They live longer, right? Than humans do? It's like this eventually, that kind of sucks for her. Because she will lose him, and then she'll continue on. I don't know, whatever. Not that my character would care. Let's take these two gold pieces. And I guess, let's just go up here real fast. Pickaxe. Prison stone. Ah, I see you right there. If I ever get a spell that can just unlock expert chests, I'll come back through all these places and just grab all the chests. I don't want to spend time trying to pick them. Alright, let's look at the letter that I got. Books. Oh god, was it just called letter or something? No, it wasn't. Crap. Probably looks like this. Aha! There we go. Gratian, I would appreciate if you could help us with the situation we've encountered in Ravenrock. It seems that the miners there have stumbled across some sort of ruins under the surface near Shaft 3, and we need your expertise to take a look. I could send someone else if you're busy, but I figured you'd want to go since I seem to recall that you're originally from Solstheim. Let us know if you make any progress. Rendellus Thandarian, East Empire Company. Shaft 3, huh? Take care, you two. Don't bicker too long. Alright. Down into the mines we go. My dwarven friend is stuck. There you go. Perhaps I should shed some light. What the? I'm sure. What the? Max is trying to climb up the wall. I'm sure you guys got it. Ooh. What the? Oh my god. Spiders. Get out of here. Sorry about this, Max. That's interesting, the shimmering effect right there. Is that like a gas? Let me level up. Don't know if there's anything else I want to do here. I don't really care about that. Can I level that? No, I cannot. Yeah, nothing there. Destruction. Most destruction spells will stagger an opponent when dual cast 25% of the time. I could start leveling up, Frost or Shock. I do have a Shock spell. Is there anything else I want to do? Maybe I just keep the point for right now. I'll just keep the point for right now. Hello, Frostbite Spider. Get out of here. Alright. Wow, another one. Interesting. Aha! And now we are into a Borrow. And Draugr are waking up. Not friendly Draugr. Good god. Alright, I can't use that. Oh boy. Right. Okay, we need to change my level 1 spell to Inferno. Oh crap. There we go. Is that it? Let's kill them with fire. Well, or any magic really works, I guess. No! He's gonna come back. Well, maybe not. Maybe not. Oh, oh! There we go. Everyone ready? Let's go further? Let's do it. We're not gonna be scared off by some undead. I mean, you wanna see some undead, I'll show you some fucking undead. Here's some undead. Ha! Welcome back, Bob. Upgraded Bob. Bow and arrow Bob. Oh. Hello? Jogger? You wanna wake up too? No? Aha! Uh-oh. You guys pushed me right next to him! You guys pushed me right next to him! Oh my god. Oh no. No, 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 no. Oh shit. Someone like locked me in here. Right next to him. I think it was my dormant guy. There we go. I'm out. Okay. Let me do this. Oh boy. I don't think we killed him with magic. We did not. He's coming back. But I got his weapon though. Try to fight now. Use your fists. Or use magic, that works too. That works too. Mother. Oh no. Oh no, no, no. I'm sorry, Gore's Warrior. Crap. Yeah, I guess that Jogger had the last laugh. I'm like, ha! I got your axe. He's like, ha! I got frost spells. I'm like, aw. Drop these. And quick save. Can I steal your soul with this? You gonna come back? Crap, I don't have a soul gem large enough to. Alright, just do it the old-fashioned way. Burn with fire. Death Lord, huh? Get him, Max. Get him, get him, get him. Ugh. Y'all dead? Ha! I'm a necromancer, damn it. I'm not gonna be beaten by Draugr. This chest, though. Ah, so close. The only reason I even want to bust into it is because it's one of the big chests. Damn it. Ah! Oh, this is terrible. Master chests are... It's too much. Too much. Ah, but I really want that. Damn it, Max. This is your fault. That looks weird. Aww. I should have killed the guy upstairs and taken his pickaxe. That's what I get for not killing people. Net's jelly. A peanut butter and Netch jelly sandwich. That sounds great. What is this? Boar tusk. Oh! Yep. Looked at the floor and I was like, wait a minute. Something's wrong with this floor. Thank you, Max. You're always a good summon there, Max. Oh boy. Let's quick save it. Oh! Sell for a pretty price. What the? Hold on. Max? Buddy? Need your help again. Thank you. Make sure that he's killed with fire. No. No. Let's go, guys. And I need to take your bow again. Thank you. Oh boy. Under the bridge. There we go. You have an ebony short bow. Don't try to get to me. You never try to get to me. All right. So what is this? Where is the lever or chain for that door? Anybody? Anyone? None of you? Probably right here. Ha ha ha! Yeah, got his body with it dangling over there now. Alright, anything over here? Aw, next for chests. No. A steel nodachi. Interesting. I didn't know the ancient Nords used nodachis. Haha. Why don't you hang around? Ha! Oh! God. Whoops. Kind of like knock that off the pedestal. There we go. Ice spike. Alright. Quick save. Well, this looks like it could be a possible ambush. Oh! Guys, I'm not done exploring that room yet. What the heck? What the hell? Wow, I don't think I've ever seen anything like that. Huh. Have you, Bob? Arrow Bob? Oh, this is not gonna work. This is not gonna work. Oh, no. I wonder. Nope, I didn't do anything. Oh my kid. Ah! Move, you piece of shit. Oh. Alright, so thanks for watching this episode, everybody. I'll figure this out, and I'll see you all next time. Take care.